The challenge of a lifetime is before us to ensure universal and equitable access to the health technologies necessary to fight COVID-19. Within and between countries, it is in the interest of everyone. If one country were to reach herd immunity, the pandemic would still be spreading elsewhere, thereby disrupting trade, supply chains, and development. In the face of an unprecedented global scenario, there is no better cure than a global cure. This crisis has also seen the rise of unprecedented inventiveness on the part of citizens, communities, universities, businesses, and among other actors to provide countries with fundamental tools in the fight against COVID-19. Mask and other personal protective equipment, ventilators, testing kits, other treatments and therapeutics. Another raise concerns the development of a possible future vaccine against COVID-19. 165 vaccines are currently in development, with 26 in clinical testing and 139 in preclinical development. While creativity and competition are driving forces of innovation and overall progress, the promise of universal, timely, and equitable access to and fair distribution of all quality, safe, efficacious, and affordable essential health technologies and products, including their components and precursors requiring the response to COVID-19 pandemic as a global priority. This was adopted last May by the World Health Assembly. This will not be achieved if we cannot guarantee access for all countries and the most vulnerable populations. This is a wake-up call. Global health needs to be prepared. In a context of so much pain in so many communities around the world, health, economic, and political actors across the globe are making the case for equitable cooperation and multilateralism as the only means we can assure the reconstruction and well-being of our societies. The need for solidarity has never been more visible or more crucial. To do so, we need to transform rhetoric and words into action. Costa Rica is committed to leverage our collective efforts to advance scientific discovery, technological development, and broad sharing of benefit of scientific advancements and its applications in the global response to COVID-19. In a matter where human health takes priority and that paves the way for a post-pandemic new era based on global cooperation and a paradigm shift towards global public goods. Back in May, Costa Rica, together with the World Health Organization, led by Dr. Tedros, and a collective movement of countries, businesses, academia, and civil society, announced the creation of a mechanism that will allow us to make available to all the health technologies required in the fight against the virus and the disease that it causes. Our solidarity call to action, supported by 41 countries, has allowed the establishment of a concrete platform to share in an open, voluntary, and collaborative way the knowledge, data, and intellectual property, making it a global public good in the attention of COVID-19 and future global health threats. As a testimony of Costa Rica's commitment, my country has made available to humanity through the hard and devoted efforts of national public institutions such as the University of Costa Rica, the Technological Institute, or the Center for Biotechnological Innovations, CENEBIOT, Technological advancements such as protocols for the manufacture of injectable preparations of hyperimmune human immunoglobulins against SARS-CoV-2 for the treatment of patients in severe and critical infections, the development of respirator prototypes, N95 masks, pneumatic mechanical ventilators, among other concrete contributions. Other key international actors have joined our collective call, also sharing what they have developed. Institutions from the United Nations dedicated to the well-being and the most vulnerable, businesses and civil society. As leaders, we have the imperative to support and make the case and commit to solidarity and international cooperation to encourage our public and private companies, as well as our research institutions, to voluntarily contribute to the exchange platform and to support the COVID-19 Technology Access Pool, CTAP, setup. Today, I thank the heads of state, heads of government, and high authorities of the countries, international organizations, and civil society representatives for their presence today, but more importantly, for their commitment and vision. Your contributions and perspectives will be the tip of the spear of global equitable vaccine, diagnostics, and therapeutic access initiatives in a new path of international solidarity. Every commitment, every step, every concrete action counts. We the peoples resounds louder than ever as a call to work collectively for true solutions, for joint actions, which will selflessly allow us to rebuild a world where the right to health is universally safeguarded. I would like also to share the specific concrete contributions of Costa Rica to this repository. One has to do with the mathematical models on the process of the disease in Costa Rica, genomic analysis of the virus in Costa Rica patients, biocomputational platform for the identification of coronavirus protective inhibitors, design of a prototype of a super cytometer for analysis of COVID-19 samples, and the platform for the parallelization of biocomputational algorithms for cell classification and tracking in digital microscopic for diagnosis of COVID-19. Also, the National High Technology Center has collaborated with the CTAP working group with the goal of producing diagnostic tests of large scale. The team led by Seneviot has made available two RNA purification protocols that contribute to technological independence, including the in-house synthesis of magnetic nanoparticles. The protocols have been shared with researchers online and will be officially included in CTAP when health permits are obtained. Another academic center, State Distance Learning University, Costa Rica, UNED, made available the information related to its nasal support face shield, whose plans and technical data sheet of the model were released to the public last April. This open face protection model was developed by the Fab Lab Catrare, with the support of the University of Costa Rica and the medical staff of the National Children's Hospital of Costa Rica. Finally, currently we are undergoing the research and the clinical trials for the equine antibodies for hyperimmunized horses, and it's currently undergoing this product of research. Information of this process would also be shared with CTAP and its results. This is our humble and modest contribution to a world effort. And I know that if each country contributes with their best, the global response will be even stronger to protect the world's health. Finally, I'd like to wish all the best in the COVAX process as well for vaccination. And I'll call it have success, and also to look for the flexible ways in to include the most vulnerable countries, because we need that for the global response. I like to say that we have already signed recently our agreement with COVAX to have access for future vaccines, but we also know that there are already need more flexible ways, so we're willing to support those efforts in order to have vaccines for everybody. I want to thank you all. I want to thank Dr. Tedros for his leadership. I wish you always wisdom. We have you in our thoughts always. So keep on with the good work, the strength to lead and to address this pandemic. And to you all, thank you very much.